Hey, Chris.
Alex, good to see you again, man.
Welcome to London.
Thank you. Thank you. It's sunny today, so it's all good.
Let's go for an autonomous drive.
Sounds
come on
good.
In.
Excellent.
All right. So we're at 10:26 in the morning in central London.
Just leaving the Microsoft office, going for a ride through Notting Hill. So what we're experiencing now is our AI driving this car through central London fully autonomously, controlling the speed, the steering, the indicators, and there's no HD map. We're not being told where or how to drive, but it's driving entirely based on what it sees. It's looking at these pedestrians around us, oncoming cars, lane markings, and making decisions entirely real time for itself. That's the level of intelligence that we've been able to learn in this model today. The big breakthrough for us last year was building our foundation model from being just dealing with single images to videos to multiple videos and multiple sensors. And at the start of last year, our AI only took a single image in and it couldn't really understand motion and dynamics. But today, this model was taking in multiple cameras, video streams from multiple cameras at the same time and understanding the surround motion around the vehicle. So you might see a lot more smooth behavior as a result.
Here's one thing I remember from when we rode in the spring of last year. Like I noticed some of the buses kind of veering a little bit towards the middle of the road. And last year, I remember when that would happen, the car would almost come to a complete stop because it wasn't sure if that vehicle was going to come all the way into our lane.
We've got a bus here and we're going to overtake it while it's parking to let passengers
off. This is a lot smoother than that was in the spring. Like we're able to go around it, navigate around it pretty well. Whereas in the spring, I think we were stopping more for safety reasons, obviously.
Sorry, let's just look at this. There's an unprotected turn. This car flashed its lights at us, and now we've driven through. This road's going to be interesting. This one is.
Yeah,
I mean, we're right in the middle of Portobello Road Market.
Navigated right through there, no problem. I love it. I can feel the ride is quite different than it was. Like it was, I would say when I was here with you last year, almost a year ago. It was definitely a little bit more of a, it was a more raw experience. Like that would have been a lot more jerky. And like
you see how we defensively slowed and pulled over when that van came towards us?
Whereas I think in the spring we might have almost stopped there.
Yeah.
Yeah, same thing on that turn right there. I thought that felt, That's definitely a difference in what we've seen. I'll be interested to see how it navigates this scenario with the car stopped in front of us like this in the opposite direction.
Let's have a look. So we're being slow. We're sort of cautiously coming around.
And it navigated that perfectly.
Tight
that
spaces as well.
That
was
tight. That was really tight. Here we go. A pedestrian who's not worried about the crosswalk.
There we go.
She's not worried about the crosswalk. She's on her phone. I love it. Like that. It's like I told you, in San Francisco, with some of the population, you get that, right? Where the light might be green, there's a don't walk sign, and they just walk right in front of you in the middle of the road. Like, and that's a very, very urban phenomenon. I would say that's my noticeable difference, is the ability to navigate some of these scenarios, but do so in a way that, you know, a human driver, as a rider, you feel it feels very smooth.
The challenge is, how do you understand and predict what's going to happen, predict how others are going to behave and how your decisions affect others around the world and around in the scene in front of you. And the Gaia world model that we produced, that's what one of the things that we think is going to be a key unlock there, giving our models the ability not just to be auto-regressive and to decide what's going to happen next, but actually understand the implications of these decisions, about to simulate how others are going to behave. And so when we think about kind of AI that's going to solve this problem, I think it's got to have the ability to understand, you know, the video motion around the vehicle. It's got to be able to predict what's going to happen next. You know, we get that from Gaia. It's got to be grounded in language so we can give it feedback and interact and build trust with it. We get that from the Lingo model we've built. And all of these kind of things, I think, will produce a model that, with the right compute data and scale, you know, we can produce the level of performance that's required for autonomy.
There we go. And it's sunny.
Yeah.
And that navigated it perfectly.
Nice. I mean, the neat thing here, right, is if you stop and are rigid and wait for all the obstacles to clear, you're going to cause so much road rage around you.
Yes.
What we've seen here is the system can fluidly navigate through traffic, including when you have obstacles and going around them and unclear lane lines. This is what you need to be able to operate in a city in a way that society will accept and trust.
You know, my presumption was always that, you know, there's two very different disciplines, and you'll have language models to do the intelligence and the explanation, and that's how we might talk to a machine or a vehicle. And then you'd have the embodied model, which would deal with all the physics of this, which is, you know, directions of travel, speed, spatial recognition, and the like. And you're telling me that the opportunity is really a multimodal model that, you know, kind of does both.
We are seeing the early signs of that model coming here at Wayve.
Okay.
A vision language action model that can understand the world, can control the car, and you can interact with it with language.
That's pretty exciting.
Well, we'll show you on the demo when we get back into the office.
Awesome.
All right, Chris.
All right.
This is Lingo. I'd love to show you this. It's a vision language action model. So it's a single AI model that's capable of understanding and seeing the world around it, driving the car, as well as interacting through language. So we've grounded driving data and language data in one foundation model. The result is it can not only drive a car, but you can talk to it, you can prompt it, you can ask it questions. Why is it doing what it's doing? What's happening around it? And you know, this is a model that we're in the process of getting live on the vehicle.
Is this an actual driving scenario, or is this something that's been created?
It's an actual one that's from our logs probably a couple of months ago. I mean, people in the past said, end-to-end deep learning is it's a black box.
Right.
You can't understand it. But this kind of technology lets us start to lift the hood and actually understand why it's doing what it's doing.
What's unique about this, you know, around the activity that's happening on this road? Obviously, it's a construction zone.
Okay, about, let's see what it says. Let's see if it sees the construction.
Construction and the pedestrians, there you go.
Right, and we believe it will allow us to do things like allow you to build trust in the system, interact mm-hmm. with it, ask it to drive in a certain way, ultimately to be able to build a relationship with the AI that's driving your car. We think it's the future.